I just turned 9 in the fall of 64 when I last visited the Deere & Company World Headquarters in Moline, Illinois. Yes, that Deere, as in John Deere Green. It's been more than 5 decades since my last visit. You see, I was effectively banned for life from the Deere property. Until a couple of years ago when I received this Facebook message from the Deere folks at Deere, saying, hey, come on back, all's forgiven. So I took him up on the offer. I don't know if I'll be back in this neck of the woods ever again, so I wanted to savor this moment and have a final look around. Oh, and I did leave my bike at home. The Deere & Company headquarters sits on 1,200 acres of rolling hills and woodlands on the edge of the cornfields. Just as you enter the property, there's this huge pond with ducks, geese, and swans. It opened in the spring of 64, just before we'd moved to Moline. And wow, looks the same as it did when I was a boy. Except maybe the trees have grown some. The headquarters was designed by a world-famous architect named Eero Saarinen. Now, as a 9-year-old, I was clueless and could have cared less who this Saarinen guy was. Until some years later, in a high school drafting class, I found out he designed the Gateway Arch in St. Louis, among other notable buildings.
We tried to express in the architecture the special character of the Deere & Company. We tried to get into the building the character of the Deere products. We tried to use steel to express strength.
First of all, it is the nature of steel to rust, and the beautiful nature of this thing that is that it rusts to a certain point and then stops rusting. So you have the color which comes about from rust. And works very well in wooded areas, for instance. If you put a weathering steel building in a wooded area, it fits in beautifully with the color of the tree stems and the tree trunks.
This is my favorite place, right here, because this is where all the boy toys are. And it's kind of neat that it's a showroom when you enter the building and you see these huge machines that are maybe taller than you are.
Well, it goes without saying that a showroom full of John Deere tractors, combines, and harvesters is like a magnet for us boys, young or old. The Deere folks seemed pretty tolerant of us kids back in the day. They'd let us climb onto the giant harvester or sit in the tractor cabs and play with all the gears and push all the buttons. Me and my pals loved to feed the huge koi that were stocked in the pond. Maybe go wading or swimming on warm days. All in all, this was paradise for us boys. Yep, those were good times, so clearly etched into my memory. We were carefree and footloose. And we loved nothing better than popping wheelies, coasting down the hillsides on our bikes, just a bunch of kids on our bicycles. What's the worst that could happen? We were walking our bikes midway up the top of that hill, all the way down to the base of the headquarters building, some 20, 30 yards. Then I lost my grip on the handlebars.
Oh, boogers!
I thought for sure it'd fall down, but it didn't. Then it hit the edge of the sidewalk. It went airborne. And I froze. I couldn't move a muscle. All I heard was shrill shrieks from the office personnel upstairs. Trust me, there was no do-over.
Run.
All of my pals ditched me like a hot potato and left me stranded to face the music on my own. To this day, I can remember waiting in that suit's office for what seemed like forever for my mom to come and pick me up. And he told her straight up, "Mrs. Barry, please don't let your son on our property again." But the worst was yet to come, when Dad came home. He stowed my bike in the rafters of the garage and grounded me for a month. And so here I am, 50 some odd years later, returning to the scene of the crime. And I recall those magical carefree days as a boy when me and my pals would play with reckless abandon at Deere Company.